Last video, I went over the first four tables of Epic Pinball.
So now we move on to Magic, Jungle Pinball, Deep Sea, and Enigma.
Magic takes its layout from a 1950s pinball table.
So maybe not a complete design, but enough to satisfy requirements.
Anyway, scoring on this table is a bit tricky. The side bumpers don't give you points like most tables, but rather change the center button's value. The bumpers on top also don't work unless you put the ball in the hole. The main objective is to light up all five slots to spell Magic.
Do this and you get 10,000 points.
This is one of three tables that doesn't give bonus points when you lose the ball. That's pretty much it for Magic and gets three pinballs out of five. Next up is Jungle Pinball,
which is homage to another game, Jill of the Jungle.
This time you have to complete multiple objectives, from spelling frog to letting apples fall from a tree.
While not overly difficult, there's so much to do.
One neat feature is when you shoot the ball up the ramp, the colors transform into mist.
I'm assuming that the view represents the mysterious jungle below?
Jungle Pinball is a solid mix of challenge and busyness and gets 3 pinballs out of 5. Next up is Deep Sea, probably the best table in the second pack.
And it's not hard to see why.
The objective is to find treasure at the bottom of the sea.
From gems to gold, you'll always find something at the bottom of the sea.
If you plan on getting a high score, this is the table for you. For starters, every time you hit a bumper, the value goes up by 500 points and it adds up pretty fast. Hitting the treasure chest hole gives you 50,000 points and goes up 50,000 points each additional time up to 300,000 points.
I could go on, but you get the idea.
One minor nitpick is that the table doesn't ripple like water to get the under-the-sea effect. Deep Sea gets 4.5 pinballs out of 5. And lastly, we have Enigma.
Perhaps the most original table of all.
This time your objective is to find the Enigma. While there are objectives, this time they're very specific and has to be done in order. When you complete the objective, you advance to the next level, the color changes, and so does the layout.
This is the only table where luck actually doesn't come into play.
One unique feature is that when you lose the ball, it changes color.
Is it safe to say that this table is enigmatic? Everyone's a critic.
Enigma is the most challenging table of the second pack and gets 4 pinballs out of 5.
Next time, Pinball Pack 3 and Cyborg Girl, Pangaea, Space Journey, Toy Factory, and African Safari.